So about 1 month ago, I teach my girlfriend Valorant. And now, she is pretty addicted. Yeah, she plays this game a lot. And there's nothing wrong with that. A girlfriend that plays games, who doesn't want that, right? But there's one thing, she's always asking me questions. Her favorite agent is Killjoy, and that's why I'm gonna make a Killjoy guide. So she doesn't ask me any questions, she can just watch this video and knows how to play Killjoy. We're gonna start with the basics of Killjoy, and the longer this video progresses, the more advanced the tips are gonna be. There are timestamps in the description, so you can skip all the boring parts and go to the part you want to see. Aye, let's start the video. Let's first talk about her abilities. You can throw her Nano Swarm down on the ground, and then you can activate it to do damage in a circle. On the defending side, it's recommended to throw them on the places where the enemies might plant the bomb. When you hear the enemy planting, just activate both Nano Swarms. A thing you can do on the attacking side is throw your nanoswarms on the bomb after you planted it. Activate your nanoswarms if you hear the enemies are defusing the bomb. Easy kills. Here's an example of one of those easy peasy kills.
Swarm grenade out. One enemy remaining.
Now let's talk about her E ability, her sentry gun. You can place it and it shoots on the enemies. The bullets of the sentry gun does almost no damage, so the main purpose of the sentry gun is for information and distraction. Try to place your sentry gun so it covers multiple angles. On the attacking side, if you for example want to cover the back, you can place your sentry gun over here. But this way the people can still walk through T-spawn to the back of you. So instead of placing your sentry over there, place your sentry over here. This way you hold both the angles. Another thing you should know about your sentry gun is that you can use it as a distraction. You can peek with it. A trick that got me many kills. How do you do it? Well, you place your sentry gun, you wait behind the box, and as soon as your sentry gun shoots, then you peek. This way, the enemy is distracted by your sentry gun, and you can kill the enemy easy peasy, like you see in the clip in the background. Now let's talk about the Q, her alarm bot. It's very simple, you just place it on the ground and when an enemy walks past it, it will make a sound and it will explode on the enemy. The explosion does no damage, but it will make the enemy vulnerable. This means that all damage on her will be doubled. This is why this ability works well together with her nano swarm. Throw your nano swarm on top of your alarm bot and when your alarm bot goes off, activate your nano swarm for easy kills. On the defending side, try to place your alarm bot on the places where the enemies might push. This way you get information without even being there. Now let's talk about the last ability, her ultimate. After placing your ultimate down, it takes 15 seconds to detonate. Everybody standing in the circle will get stunned. This means that they can't use their gun anymore. When you are using your ult, always look at your minimap and place it on a place where you get the most angles. So don't place there in middle. I just did that because it looked cool. When you use your ult, don't push immediately after your ult. Because it takes 15 seconds till the enemies get stunned. Wait for around 10 seconds and then push. This way, you know for sure the enemies either push to you or they went to a safe spot. Because they have to push, they can't stay in your ult. So they either come to you or go away. In the background, you see an example of a good timing.
One enemy remaining.
You saw that the enemy just walked right into my crosshair. Here's another example. In this clip I waited 10 seconds till I pushed. When I pushed, the enemies were away and the only place the enemy killjoy could be was in a corner. This was because the corner in boathouse was the only place safe on B side. So I rushed to that corner, aimed there and made an easy kill. Got him. Aight, those were the basics. Now let's go to the setups. Setups are very important when you play Killjoy. A setup is when Killjoy uses her abilities so they work very well together. Let's first talk about the defensive setups. On the defending side you have two types of setups, an aggressive and a defensive setup. With an aggressive setup you place your sentry so that you get early information about the enemies. An example is over here on Ascent. This sentry gun knows when people are in A main, because it can aim all the way to A main. In the background you see that if people are standing over here, the sentry knows that the enemies are there and they will shoot on the enemy. A defensive setup is when you place the sentry so that it will only shoot when the enemies are on side. An example is over here. If you place the sentry over here on ascent, the sentry will only shoot when the enemies already pushed. So why should you use one time an aggressive and one time a defensive setup? Well, they both have their strengths and weaknesses. With the defensive setup, if enemies enter the site, they can get peeked from all the corners. And when there's a sentry, they will get distracted and it will be chaotic. And in conclusion, you will get easy kills. The only problem with the defensive setup is that you will not get information till the enemies are on site. With an aggressive setup, you will get that early information. This way you can easily call it to your teammates and rotate earlier. The problem with the setup is that the enemies can see your sentry, they will probably destroy it. And then it's up to the enemy if they want to push or not. Because they can just rotate. rotate back if they want to. So when should you use which one? Well, it's very easy, switch things up. Try to never use the same setup if the enemy saw your setup in the round before. This way you always stay unpredictable. However, if the enemies didn't see your setup, you can use the same setup, of course. And you can also use the same setup later in a game. Just don't be predictable, you know? Now let's talk about the setups itself. There are a lot of ways you can set up a site. And in this video, I won't talk about all the setups you can make, because there are a lot. However, I can show you an example of a setup over here, on Bind. So for the defensive setup on B, I like to put my turret over here. This is defensive because the turret only shoots when the enemies are on site. So here for long, only if they peek over here, the turret will shoot. And here for a hookah, only if they jump down, the turret will shoot. Then I would place my alarm bot over here, and my nano swarm over here, and over here. Now, when people jump down, they have no chance of surviving, because I can just activate my nano swarm if my alarm bot goes off, and my sentry will shoot on them. And on top of that, I will peek and make the kills. And this is only one setup of like 50 setups you can do on this side only. So be creative with your setups. Now, let's talk about the attacking side. How do you play Killzone on the attacking side? Well, it's very simple. You use your abilities to counter the push. For example, on Haven A, you can place your turret over here. And then you're gonna push C with your teammates. As soon as you get out of the range of your turret, you'd call your turret back and you push on site with your teammates. This way, when you're on site and plant the bomb, your turret cooldown will be off and you can use it to defend the bomb. And after you planted the bomb, throw your nano swarms on top of the bomb, your alarm bot somewhere on top of the bomb, and easy peasy. And of course, you can also save one nano swarm for a lineup. Now, I will give you a few tips and tricks for playing Killjoy. First one, be unpredictable. On the defensive side, try to use different sites so you don't play all the time A, but also go B sometimes. Second one, try to hide your nano swarms. For example, here on Beambind, you can place your nano swarm inside of the container. When you activate it, it will catch all the default plants and the enemies cannot destroy it. If you are in a smoke, you can use your sentry gun to get information. Use your sentry gun a little bit out of the smoke and look if it shoots. If it shoots, there's an enemy behind the smoke. If it doesn't shoot, then behind the smoke is clear and you can push. If the enemies destroy it, you know for sure there's someone behind the smoke. Big brain plays over here. If your alarm bot hits someone, don't aim for the head, but aim for the body. This is because your weapon now does double damage, so most of the time you only need 2 shots in the body to get a kill. Easy. Try to at least learn your post-plant lineups. This way the enemies won't be able to destroy your nano swarms if you place them directly on the bomb. Luckily for you, I made a video about the lineups. You can click on the top right corner if you want to see that video. Killjoy, her abilities are very expensive, so don't use your abilities in eco rounds. Except your sentry, of course. Or if you are very, very rich. When you are placing your turret, try to place your turret high. Because this way the enemy will have to flick up instead of to the left or the right. And flicking up or down is way harder. OG viewers knew that this was coming, but Killjoy can do the teleport trick. Throw your nano swarm through the teleporter. The teleporter door will open, push behind the nano swarm and get some easy kills.
Nice.
You can use your ult in combination with your nano swarm. For example here in Ascent, if you place your ult over there and you throw your nano swarm over here, then your nano swarm will land on the only place the enemy players can hide. You can use this to retake sites. In the future, I will make more videos with lineups like this. Don't use your abilities if you know enemies are pushing. I mean, I never do that. And the last tip, just stay sneaky peeky and only peek when your sentry gun is shooting. Alright, now I will show you an in-game example. In this clip, it was a 2 versus 3. I had the possibility to flank behind the enemies, so of course, I did that. Left side.
One enemy remaining.
Got him. I left my turret standing in mid, and it shot, so we knew that Raze was in middle. So I took the spike, and while I was walking on site, I used my alarm bot on the hallway. This way, if Raze walked to the right, I knew she was there. I also used my nano swarm on top of the alarm bot, so if my alarm bot went off, I could use my nano swarm and hit her for a lot of damage.
Last player standing. Found them. Bomb grenade out.
Sadly, I did not make the kill over here, but because my nano swarm was there, I knew she was low, so I pushed a little bit aggressively. Nice! Alright, I hope everyone learned something. En Anne, ik hoop dat jij even gaat ownen met Killjoy. Ik geloof dat jij het kan. Je kan het gewoon. Je doet het eventjes. If you want to see more videos of me, click on the video on the right, and I see you in the next one. Peace.